Yes, I'm not afraid to say that this nation is still undemocratic. I have not seen democracy. All I've seen is hypocrisy. I hear the cry of the poor people crying for food. Hunger that is invited by adapting the foolish ideologies of IMF and World Bank. But why should Africa be used to confuse and refuse, or rather, tossed like a bowl by Europe and America? Why should we cry too loud to be left free? Of course not. I don't understand it when I see Kabila being unhappy. I'm not Buyoya, I'm not West. What's the difference? They all took power by the bullet. Yet I see Kabila giving a hero's welcome for AU. All African traders are ready to do business with him. Is it because there is diamond in Congo, which you want to share at the expense of the poor people in Congo? No. I thank Mandela and Kabila for telling America that our enemies are not the same. And fully, I salute Saddam for reminding America that the world will never be ruled by one nation. America, America, and new colonials. Yes, let your food stand as an example to all African leaders. So one day you may die and have not one head of state nor your family. It's about time the world woke up and see that America can produce good music, movies and fashion. But at the same time, can I produce no yet? Look at Sabine, made you. Africa is not a testing ground for your new weapon. You ask me if I'm not afraid of the people. I'll tell you no, I'm not afraid of the people. Looking at the living conditions of most Malawians, to be in prison or outside prison makes no difference. Our country is in African. Do you really want to know why? Go to the hospital and you see doctors and nurses drinking coffee when poor patients are dying and attending in the college. And the minister is supposed to say nothing. Because when he's sick, two flights are not being guaranteed. Now go to police and you cry. You see the accused dying in jail cells like hybrid chickens. You see a policeman killing and nothing is done. All you see is the killer out on bail 2 days late. You see a policeman using a button stay for criminals advanced with AK-47. Oh yes, you see the public writing information from the police. But of course, blaming the police on the first combative crime. Try to take a bus in the M1 tarmac and you'll be delayed and safe on all the 6 roadblocks. But when white people, Indians, rich people and politicians are passing with their Mercedes-Benz, BMW, full of drugs and guns in the hood, all they receive is a heavy salute by the polite police. But truly, who can carry a gun on the bus? You need to know that a gun is an expensive device. So armed robbery is a crime done by the rich. Poor people may only be used in the force. Go to education and you see money blaming candidates when examinations are false, instead of looking into their own security system. You cry to see the standards of education going lower and lower for the poor people, while the sons and daughters of politicians are getting quality education. Go to water board, they will tell you that water is a problem because of rain. Yet you see it and lose while millions of liters of clean water go to the Zambezi River every hour. Just close the water board, you will see Esco, this star performer. He's blaming the poor people for environmental degradation. But with power so expensive, how do you save the trees from being used as fire? Sorry, that was a blackout again. The savings are getting poor, but costs are getting high. What do you expect from our people? Go to NBC and you discover the radio is still undemocratic. It's still buying. It's still just a notice board for politicians. Why should MPC choose non-political music on it and claim to be democratic at the end of the day? Why should reporters abuse their own profession just to entertain politicians? And the same problem is found in our newspapers. It has become clear that if you buy Daily Times, you're going to see nice stories about MCG. And if you buy The Nation, you're going to hear nice stories about UDM. When shall we see freedom of expression? Now let's talk about TV. I understand and know that people started getting paid some 2 years ago, but this box is not shown. You know what I see when I switch on my TV? Okay, let's talk about sports. Let's go to the TV stadium and watch football. Every time we lose, 4-0, 5-1, 6-0, 10-0. Well, but farm is to blame. Look at our boys playing football but getting no pay. Remember the unnecessary banning of battle. Why should the youth be criticized all the time? Why should the minister go to a meeting we're supposed to be given to a coach? Now listen to this embarrassing story of womanizing among the ministers. Why should a respected person do such a thing as taking somebody's woman? Well, there are lots of single ladies on the streets. With such behavior, who will tell the children about AIDS? Who will restore morals in our community? Is this why you allow PSI to advertise condoms more than telling the people about the dangers of AIDS? Human life has more value to be protected by a plastic tube. Is this why you allow family planning clinics to carry out abortions, pretending you don't know when thousands of unborn babies are killed legally every year? This humanizing is a sign of too much money in the pocket. Wrong pocket for that matter. While we are suffering. Too much corruption. Indians and Lebanese taking up our market, yet we just vendors outside. And why is duty for Tanzanians, yet we leave Indians and the paying Malawians? I even heard one tell me, Zikoduwanu Dalama Diwatu. Maybe he was right. Look at the cars stolen like shoes, children missing like notebooks. It's only when it's a child of a white man that you see the story in the paper. Oh, my poor Malawi. And when all these bad things are happening, members of the opposition don't seem to say anything. They're just waiting to be bought like a commodity of trade by UDA. All opposition parties, they don't tell me anything good. All I hear them saying is, we want to go back to Sanjeev. Or you just can't go to heaven without faith. Show us the reason we should respect you. You did not make it in 30 years. Now, will you do a thing in 5 years? And if you could force Kamuzu to punish people for nothing, what about now when you're in charge? Oh, MCP without Kamuzu, without Kamuzu, I don't know. Social Democratic Party, rest in peace. MPP, gone and forgotten, just waiting for elections. PDP, back to business, selling Maritaka. UN, unfaithful as a secretary. How faithful as a president? We know the way. Come on, my name is the one here. Rastafari.